Mike Emrick is sought out by all of the networks, by everybody, because he's the king.
No, there's no comfort level here, nor will there be until the first water comes from the shower.
The first network opportunity I got was with ESPN. That was in the mid to late 80s. Later, other opportunities would come, Fox. There were ABC games done in affiliation with ESPN that I got a chance to do. After the lockout versus came along, as did NBC. So I was lucky that I've been with all of those various alphabet letters. But I guess as you look back on it, I can't hold a job. I still get goosebumps thinking about various moments that have come up in my career. Game 4, Western Conference Final, Dallas at Detroit, 1998. Vladimir Konstantinov was a part of the Detroit team that won in 97, but then the tragic limousine accident, and he hadn't really been seen that much since. But during a stoppage of play in that fourth game, Bud Lynch, the PA announcer, mentioned that he was there.
Welcome back, number 16, Vladimir Konstantinov!
I guess I couldn't gauge the amount of love the Red Wings fans had for him and how they could express it and how it would be so loud, nor did I have any idea at all that it would get to me as much as it did. 1999, Wayne Gretzky had hinted that he might retire. He announced that that was going to be his final game early in that last week. And Fox changed its plan on what it was going to do.
Gretzky feeds Schneider, but it's one in front, they score!
That was the last game. We stayed on quite a while, and nobody complained, because Wayne came and went three times to the locker room, came back out, and the ovations were just as long.
The last word on a wonderful career belongs to the fans.
As I stood outside Madison Square Garden watching a team that had missed the playoffs, their fans were coming out and there were smiles on every face because they'd seen something spectacular. They had seen the legend play his last game.
Snowy day, celebration of hockey in Buffalo.
January 1, 2008, Ralph Wilson Stadium in Buffalo. We have been through two periods, and it was pretty decent in the first, it sleeted the second. So in it sweeps for the whole third, and in the shootout, the referee at center had actually lost sight of the puck that Sid was stick handling with because there was so much snow around it. Fortunately, Sid didn't lose it.
Score! Penguins win!
And Don Van Massenhoven, the referee on the goal line, sneaked the puck into his pocket and got two-thirds of the way to the referee's room before somebody tapped him on the shoulder and said, the league wants all the puck.
There's certainly a pride to see Mike be getting his due, but what makes you feel the best is him getting the accolades that he has most recently received.
Ladies and gentlemen, the voice of the Devils for nearly two decades, our friend Mike Doc Emrick.
It was the 30th of January of this season. The Devils had wanted to do something to honor my having been taken into the Hall of Fame and with the Foster Hewitt Award.
Thank you for honoring our family. Thank you for honoring me and hockey. Thank you, Devils. Thank you, Penguins. Put on a great show. I know you will.
We've always said that we'd like our team to be considered an orchestra, and everybody has a role to play. And Michael is part of that orchestra.
9 months out of the year, I live out of a suitcase. And the packer of that suitcase is my wife of 30 years. She has not only been understanding of the fact that this is the passion that I have and the work that I enjoy, but also that that means that she has to have a life of her own for a lot of a period of time. And I owe that to her, not to myself. I've just gotten to do what I've enjoyed doing.
Hi, how are you guys?
Love your work.
Thank you very much. Thank
really
you.
Too. Let me just
what
show
number
you
do you have?
The best thing about Mike is that he's all inclusive. He's a regular guy. Even though he's the best in the business, there's no pretense about him.
Well, you got plenty of signatures there, didn't you?
Yeah.
What is that one?
And I think that this business of Mike being natural, regular, is very special because he brings all of his hockey background right to the present telecast, and that to me is the best.
Drive, knocked down in front, rebound, score! Parise again!
As Ernie Harwell, who I always quote, the legendary baseball broadcaster, says, a man's lucky if God gives him a job he enjoys. And I think any gifts that we have are from God, and I think that oftentimes our lives get plotted out that way, and I've just counted myself very fortunate.
Their ship has come in. 11 wins in the last 13 games. Unbelievable how well it's going for this team.